Like all companies, SuitShop operates in a specific market context along with its competition, so it's important to understand that context when suggesting ideas and initiatives. Knowing what the competition is doing, as well as what is and isn't working in the industry, will make sure your idea stands out from the crowd and is aligned with current trends. You might start with industry reports in IBIS World and Passport GMID, which identify potential products and markets, as well as threats and opportunities companies in this industry are facing. Let's look at this IBIS World report entitled Online Men's Clothing Sales. You'll note this report is not about suits, specifically. That's because individual product categories are rarely treated as a separate industry. That's okay, though, because the trends and challenges in this report will apply to all products in this category. You can start with the Industry Performance tab to see how things have been going and why, and then see the Industry Outlook tab for a projection of what may happen in the near future. The Products and Markets tab talks about office and formal wear specifically, and also talks about which consumer segments are buying men's clothing online. See the Competitive Landscape tab for factors that contribute to success in this industry. And there's also a bit of information here on the key competitors in this industry. You should make a note of their names and search for more information about them in news and company databases like MarketLine and Nexus Uni. Because many of SuitShop's competitors are private companies, the amount of information you'll find on them is limited. But you can look in MarketLine for SWOT analyses of Tailored Brands and Macy's, and also search for news on the companies in databases like Factiva and Nexus Uni. This is just one of several useful reports in IBIS World, so you want to look in the same sections of other reports found here, like online women's clothing sales, men's clothing stores in the U.S., women's clothing stores in the U.S., and the reports on plus-size clothing for both men and women. Passport GMID is another source for industry performance and trend data. You might search for these reports on men's wear in the U.S. and women's wear in the U.S. The easiest way to find these reports is to select Analysis next to the search box. Type men's wear or women's wear into the search box, but don't hit Return. Instead, choose View All Results from the bottom right corner of the suggested reports panel that appears. Then, either scroll to find the report for the U.S., or select the U.S. from the Geographies tab on the left. These reports discuss industry trends, and the section on prospects and opportunities could provide useful ideas and insights. Statista can also provide good insights into the industry. Try searching for reports on fashion e-commerce, men's apparel, women's apparel, and weddings. Blue icons indicate standalone charts, while orange, red, and green icons are reports and dossiers that contain many charts on a topic. Finally, you can browse recent issues of fashion magazines and newspapers like Women's Wear Daily, Vogue, and the New York Times Style section to see what's trending. Find links for these publications on your research guide. Now that you have a sense of the industry and the competition, you can check out the video on consumer research to learn about consumer behaviors and brand strategies to make sure your idea will have buy-in from shoppers.